So I'm here today with Mark Johnson, who's a professor at Pittsburgh State University in Pittsburgh, Kansas. And we're at the Apprenticeship Conference for the International Foundation for Employee Benefit Plans. And Mark, you talk and blog and write a lot about education, and you talk about this thing called the latency effect, and I'm fascinated by it. Tell us what the latency effect is.
Simply put, when we learn something, it goes dormant or latent until we apply it. Basically, it's like when you were in math class and you learned an equation. Okay, that's good, but when am I going to use this in real life? And then all of a sudden, a couple of years later, you're working on a project at home, and all of a sudden, oh, that's what that is. And the lights come on, the bells ring, and we got it. It was latent because you learned it, but you didn't do anything with it until you needed to do something with it and apply it. That's what you mean.
But Mark, the longer the time between when you hear it and when you actually practice it, the greater the chance that you'll actually forget it.
Absolutely.
Right?
So what we have to do is we have to work on eliminating or minimalizing latency effects. So the best thing to do is what we need to do is to teach it and have them apply it as soon as they get the material.
So in an apprenticeship program, what does this mean?
So for example, when I'm teaching let's say I'm teaching a task. Let's say for example, I'm a carpenter teaching somebody how to build a rafter. Instead of me laying out the wood, building the rafter, and then say, okay, here's the wood, you go build me one. Instead, I lay out the rafter, they lay out their rafter. They do the next step, or I do the next step, they do the next step. And every time they do it, I coach them, good job, or no, you need to straighten that a little bit, you need to make an adjustment. I make sure they follow the step exactly as I did and give them feedback. Once we've done that, we go to the next step. And then when the task is done, I'm done, they're done. And they have successfully completed what I just taught them to do.
So essentially you've gotten rid of the latency between the learning and the using.
It's automatic, there is no latency. Once they learned it, they immediately apply it.
So what happens when I send somebody off to Microsoft.NET or SQL Server training for a week?
Okay.
And they haven't had a chance to use any of it. How do I get rid of that latency?
So what we have to do is we apply whatever they're learning and we come up with applications so it happens immediately. Now remember that there's got to be a replication of practice here. We know in marketing, for example, you got to see things about four times before you get it. So if I'm teaching a skill, I'm going to teach it the first time step by step with them with me, and they have done it correctly. So the next time I'm going to say, okay, here's the stuff, you do it again, I'm not going to say anything, but I'm going to watch you, and I'll correct you if you need help. The third time, I'm going to have them look at each other, and they're going to do it for each other and do peer evaluations. Because we know according to Bloom's taxonomy, evaluation is the highest level of learning. And what better way to do it than to coach and teach each other. And then the fourth time, they're going to turn around and they're going to do it for me again. And they've done it correctly four times in a row.
And that's why they say knowing how to teach something is really the best way to learn something.
Absolutely.
Mark, thank you so much. And Mark, you're on LinkedIn.
I'm in LinkedIn. I do blogs about weekly with posts about learning and teaching and helping others improve their lives.
All right. Well, we'll include a link in the description. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching The Matrix Minute. Don't forget to connect with us on our blog and social media. For more information, go to matrixgroup.net.